Okay, you just made it to work. It is, let's see, 7:25, and my daily ritual is when I get to work, Craftwell is on between 7 and 7:30, which I really don't watch. But I just leave the television on to keep the spirit and atmosphere. 7:30, Bishop David Evans. It's a blessing that I could come to work and I'm able to watch the Word Network, TBN, things like that. I work at a faith-based organization, and I can basically pray, worship, watch TV until 9 o'clock, and I have to be here at 7, so you can't tell me God is good. I just feel really, really good today. Don't know what the day's going to hold, don't know what the week's going to hold, but I know the promises of God and what He promised me. Glad that my family woke up today, no matter how crazy they may be, and how many different things that we all have going on, different personalities, different misconceptions, you know, the average things that goes on in families, but I think ours may be a little extreme sometimes. I still love my family. Miss them. Kids still act crazy sometimes. Jalen, Janae, love them to pieces though. Give them to God and just keep moving. And I'm just focusing on, you know, doing the right thing, not having good ideas, but having God ideas. And just maintaining my relationship with the Lord and focusing on being an awesome mom to the little one, which is Jared. My twins are almost 20. They feel they have more options, and the Lord Jesus Christ is not one of them at this moment. Just pray for them. Anyway, yeah, I just really feel good. As you can see, when I'm in a good mood, I play with my hair. See? So, I don't know. I'm just very happy today. Very perky. I woke up today. A lot of people can't say that. Everyone's mom didn't wake up today. Sister, daughter, etc., etc. So, I just thank God for that. And I give Him all the glory and honor. Like I was saying before, over the weekend, it was good. It was great. My son was just very elated to see his father. Been praying for his dad to know the importance of being a father. And I think it's working. Prayer does work. Prayer changes things. And I have high hopes for what God's going to do in my son's life with his father. I pray that he realizes that your first ministry is your son before anything else. And I pray that he gets that. I do. He's very, very churchmatic. Very churchmatic. Which I used to be like that as well. But I learned balance. I was very churchmatic when my twins were younger. And I think that's what's wrong with the church still. You know, they teach us how to be... I'm still playing with my hair. That's so funny. Because I'm in a good mood. But anyway, you know, the church teaches us how to be like these great evangelists, first ladies, cheer ladies, district missionaries. But they don't focus on being, you know, a good mother, a good wife, a better wife, a good daughter. The same with the men. They teach them to aspire to be these bishops and pastors, superintendents, district superintendents, ministers in training, things like that. But they need to focus on being a better son, you know, better individual. Build your character, build your integrity, because if you have sloppy integrity as you're growing into the things that you think you want to do, once you become a pastor, you'll still be sloppy and raggedy. Once you become a bishop, you'll still have character flaws, which we all do to a certain extent, but the church needs to focus on teaching what's right. You need to take care of your wife and be a good father before you worry about getting ordained and building a new church and manifest and things like that. But that's neither here nor there. I know it's going to be like that until Jesus comes, but it's great to find different ministries that do push the importance of family and things like that. So, I know I kind of went on a tangent. I don't know. Alrighty. God bless you, and I'll be back soon. Bye-bye.